Jiggy, how's it going? The editing tutorials are finally here. I've had a few people ask me to make some, so I'll be going over some pretty beginner Premiere Pro tips, and I'll try to expand on those topics in a way that can still benefit more intermediate learners, you know? For those of you who don't know, my name is Jiggy, also known as Jiggy Puff Fridays. I am a YouTube content editor. My main job is to take Twitch live streams, also referred to as VODs, and cut them down to roughly 10 to 12 minutes to upload for YouTube, primarily for the streamer Trick2G, and I've accumulated over 120 million views. No cap! I've also worked with Shifter, a pro league streamer, Morgoss, the winner of the summer skirmish at PAX West for Fortnite, and a few other guys. Hopefully, with this past experience, you trust me enough to know I'm trying to give quality tips. Please note, however, I am not perfect. If you're an editor and you think you know a better way for any of these tips, please comment or send me a Twitter DM. You can send me a DM regardless if you have any questions, and I'll try to respond. In future videos, I will be addressing any other concerns you might have, such as finding a job, you're finding your style of editing, working with specifically Twitch content, and a whole variety of other topics. We're gonna start off with the bread and butter tool that you'll be using, hopefully, for every video from now on. Audio fades! Audio fades are basically cross fades for sound. You're probably wondering what that means. When you have two adjacent audio clips play from one to another, the sudden change of sound sometimes results in a click, or an unwanted sound.
What the fuck?
Like a video crossfade, an audio fade gradually shifts the content of the first clip to the second clip. For the sake of simplicity, you can think of gain like volume for now. Please note, however, they are not the same thing. But if you want to learn more, just Google gain versus volume. Music producers will beat you up if you say they're the same, so be careful. There are three types of audio fades in Premiere, and the one that I use, and the one that we'll be using in this tutorial, is constant power. Head over to the effects tabs, go to audio transitions, and drag and drop it in between two clips. You can double click the transition to control how fast the transition will be. You can also use it to slowly fade in a song on a single clip or a sound instead of having to keyframe it. The shortcut for this effect is Control Shift D. You can also change the default transition time in settings. I recommend you don't ever have it less than 3 frames.
Number 2.
Transitions have a huge impact on how the flow of your video goes. A common mishap new editors do is that they'll add a transition in between every single clip. Most editors that I know will say videos are kind of like a story. I add on to that knowledge by saying transitions help mark the beginning or end of a chapter in that story. While editing League of Legends, for instance, I'll use transitions to go from one side of the map to another, from one teamfight to the next, or simply from champ select to in-game, from chapter 1 to chapter 2. I would say dodge most of the default transitions. Like, they're usually corny, cheesy, unless that's what you're going for. You know, cheesy and corny could be funny themselves. I personally use Video Hive's Premiere Pro Transition Pack. It's easy to use. I just drag and drop it onto the timeline, and I think it looks so professional. An affiliated link in the description if you do want to check it out.
Number 3.
Cutting at 2x speed. Cutting, also known as clipping, is a job where you just sit down and sift through the longer piece of content looking for highlights or the clips of the longer piece. This is especially applicable for me because I mostly edit League of Legends content. There's a lot of dead space between fights and the audio is very clear. This doesn't work with noisy environments and multiple people talking at once. You need to pay attention to the words so you can catch a joke or something. Be your own judge and don't try to use this on every type of content. See if it fits for you. This is how I cut at 2x speed even faster, so you're gonna have to remember a few buttons. First, you have to have a sequence open, and you're gonna have to learn to use the source window. Remember these keys: J to go slower, K to pause, or use space if you're gonna keep pausing and playing, L to go faster. This is a bit harder now, but bear with me. Remember I to mark in and O to mark out. What you're doing here when you mark is that you're isolating or taking a section of the content from the source, comma and dot. These buttons will take that section of content and drop it into the timeline. Comma will divide your sequence like Moses and place that section wherever your play marker is. If anyone knows the real name for that, by the way, the play marker, please let me know. Period will try to softly place it on top of whatever content you have on the timeline already. Fun fact, these hotkeys work for YouTube videos as well. J to go back 10 seconds and L to go forward 10 seconds and K to play and pause.
Number 4.
Keyframe easing. This method will be just a little bit jank. All of us editors have made that videos with that choppy, hard looking keyframe, you know, fucking smacks the middle of the screen looking like a block. It's like very blocky, it's nasty, it's not something that you want. You want it to be smooth. You can smooth it out in After Effects using the graph editor, but we're trying to dodge After Effects entirely and do it on Premiere. So the absolute smoothest way I found to do keyframes is just don't use the default position keyframes at all. Instead, type transform into your effects and drag and drop the effect onto a clip. I like to press ease out on the first keyframe and ease in on the second, creating this kind of bell curve. Depending on whether the clip is accelerating or decelerating, I pull the appropriate side straight out, like Jenga. With shit like scale and some other keyframes, you have to do this weird thing where it goes up and down. So you have to be like a little mini game and try to keep it 100% straight or movement will look very odd. Keep Control Z on deck, bruh. That shit will save your life using this technique.
Tip number five.
Black screen emphasis. I don't know what this is called, but it's something I use a lot. It's kind of a personal pocket tip, but I think it's still pretty useful. You need to understand a little bit about masking for this one. If not much else is happening on the screen, and say the streamer is educationally talking about an item in their inventory, you can add a black screen to your project, put it over the footage, and mask the thing you want to emphasize on. Use feather and opacity so it's just not a black screen, and instead darkens it, and invert it so the colors switch. And use keyframes to gradually shift your viewer's attention from one element to the other. That's about it for the main tips, honestly. I still got three quick bonus ones, so thank you for sticking with me this long into the video. They're not going to be as in-depth as the ones I've just mentioned in the video, but they should still help you with your workflow. Audio management. Have the entirety of your video around the same audio level. Use the gain monitor to help keep track, and try not to have the audio levels reach red. I like to keep mine under -6 gain. Edit audio levels quickly by selecting a clip, pressing G, and changing the audio levels from there. Exporting to YouTube. You're probably looking at that export screen like, what the heck am I looking at? There's so many options. Well, there's a simple solution. Just pick H.264 and then pick YouTube 1080p or whichever resolution your video is at. It'll do the rest. All you gotta do is press export. Sharing your videos to clients. I used to use mega.co.nz since they offer 50 gigabytes of free storage, but they do limit how much you can download in a period of time. Like, they fucking cap it. So now I just use Google Drive's annual 100 gigs plan. I'd recommend keeping your videos around for a little while just in case the client wants to change something, or maybe you wanna use that video again in the future, but only a clip of it, so you upload it to the cloud. But yeah, I recommend Google's annual 100 gigabyte plan. That's all for this video. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Maybe find it helpful and leave a like if you did. Let me know if you have any questions and I'll try to address them in a future video, or maybe just address them to you personally if you DM me them. So thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.